I will call the regular meeting of the Borough County Council to order, and I will recognize Councilwoman Kathy Conlon to lead us to the pledge of allegiance to the occasion.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Dear Lord, tonight, give us the wisdom and your guidance so that we make correct decisions for the town, and help me persuade some of this group to my way of thinking. But most of all, let us be thankful for all our blessings for living in this town and having so many good people around us. We ask all of this in your son's name. Amen.
Amen.
Next item is reading of the minutes from April 21st, 2015. Is there a motion for approval as written?
There is.
And second?
Second.
Any discussion? There was one thing, and I could be wrong, but page two, under new business, item A, it says after some discussion, vote for first reading was unanimous. And I was thinking I voted against it, and then I went back and looked at my little notes on the item A, and I had 4-1. So I don't know if we just need to check that on the video and see, but I was thinking I had voted against it. I don't know if anybody else.
I don't remember.
I had a note 4-1, but so that didn't mean anything to me. Thinking it was 4-1, but I knew it was.
You could put the mayor for being his obstructive self and voting no.
But anyway, that's the only change, and I live.
No, I keep numbers, you did vote that.
I was thinking I did, but okay.
Did you vote against it?
Yeah.
A lot of times I go back and double check and on the tape.
But we can double check it for sure.
I'll double check it.
Make another.
Sure.
But all in favor of being approved with that correction there, that needs to be corrected there. Do so with your opinion. Mr. Brown, anything?
No, sir.
Any questions, Mr. Brown?
Can you get that annual school grant?
No, sir, so I haven't found out about the hospitality grant. I mean, you did get through the accommodation one. I put that out before we. I called Sarah Stallion, which she's one that was letting me know, and they haven't voted that yet. I haven't gone to council for the hospitality.
That was $40,000.
The hospitality was the $40,000, yes, and the accommodation was the $20,000 we didn't get. So we do have a chance to get all of it, none of it, some of it. Still no idea.
Did they give you a reason why they didn't get in the top seller?
They don't have to.
No.
Any other questions for Mr. Brown? The next item is receipt of communications. Any receipt of any communication?
I saw that Tiffany is resigning from.
Yeah.
Change it.
Really on. They're doing a search right now and hoping to have applications resumes in by the end of May, do their interviews in June and hire somebody early July so that they can train with her for a month.
I also saw on here, says she's So that, when I mean, look for, and everybody come on board, it's nice clothes, the old wood system, that, and then they're all.
We'd be wasting time and money, but for someone else, when we got a good fit.
In our defense.
Nobody else on the streets working on the road?
Well, Jay.
I'm sure one of them will move up the captain, yes.
Jay couldn't get a job, so we're not gonna hire him, but do you remember, we did this when we hired Brian, were you around then? Anyway, and it all boiled down, and we interviewed a lot of people, and he was the best in many ways.
That's what I'm saying, well, so you interviewed a bunch of people when we hired Brian, but not when Brian leaves, not everybody.
But we've learned.
You learned what?
We've learned that once you train them and get them broken in well, that you ought to hire them as city employees.
So any other received communications?
There's one more, I keep getting emails from these military people about Mr. Carr's flagpole.
About his flagpole?
Mr. Carr, who's not dead?
I'm not.
Are we still doing the flag phase, but did we put that in budget, I know I forgot.
We have put nothing in the budget, council has discussed some alternatives, we thought maybe we could build like miniature wall out there, we could put little flag signs.
Okay, so we're still thinking about this, okay.
Because there are a lot more veterans and people in your area, or from our area, we haven't had any guidelines established, I need qualified to put on the wall.
Okay.
So you would get prices on the wall and.
I'm still waiting, I've got a monument coming down, I love it, but we don't know how big we wanna make it. Probably put it somewhere by the flagpole out there in the veterans park, but how big we make it, who qualifies to go on the wall, those are things we have to discuss.
Okay.
Do we have to grow in Irma, or just live in Irma, we probably have thousands.
We might.
In the neighborhood.
Yeah.
So that's the thing we've got to discuss, if we're gonna accept anybody, whether it be an uncle, grandfather, distant cousin, or someone who lives here, who's in the military, that would determine how big the wall needs to be.
And if we have a fee on this plaque, if they pay the fee, that could have something to do with it too.
This plaque is involved for, just for.
Veterans.
Veterans, or just?
Veterans, World War II.
Not necessarily veterans, but people who have served.
I mean, my son-in-law is in the military, he's going to Afghanistan, so, I mean, if he gets it back okay, that's great, but if he comes back in a body bag or anything, does he don't have to go on that wall?
Wouldn't qualify, if that's what our criteria is, yeah.
We don't want to question, I think he ought to go on the wall, but even if he comes back alive, just for building.
I'm paying a lot of kids, okay, not just my son, but a lot of students that I know are serving over.
That's what I'm saying, if you could ask an honest number, if we could open a.
I guess that's what I was asking, just for World War II. Just for World War II, or just veterans.
That's what we need to discuss, and we haven't yet.
Okay, thank you.
Where'd you get some ideas from that cost of that wall? And, $50 or $100, that we could kind of, been deciding, you know, 50-foot wall, 100-foot wall, 10-foot tall, 20-foot tall, or.
Right, we need to, again, decide how far back you want to go forever, or one, Civil War, you know.
One, darn, I think you got it. Okay.
Next item is, or is any more received communication, did you? Next item is presentation by citizens, this is where anyone who wants to address Irma County Council or anything, is on the agenda tonight. They do so at this time, audience, if you give us your name and address for the record, and then what agenda item you want to address. Anyone who wants to address the council. Next item is unfinished business, second reading of ordinance 1504. to amend the Irma code. This is the one the Water Truck Commission has section 267, Lake Murray, under the control. Is there a motion for second reading?
So moved.
And second?
Second.
And any discussion on that?
You've got my name tagged to it, because I made some comments about this last meeting. Item C, and I think it looks like you may have corrected it or put the portion that we was in item C. It says the Lake Murray Irma Women's Club will not be charged any participation fee and allowed to keep 100% of revenue during the Oak Trust Festival. The 100% of revenue during the Oak Trust Festival. I just wanted to point that out. That's what I had asked last time.
We need to make an amendment.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
So do I need to make that in the form of an amendment?
Yeah, just an amendment.
And if it passes, then this will be worked correctly. I'd like to make a friendly amendment to part C. After the word keep, excuse me, add 100% of revenue during the Oak Trust Festival. Period.
It's already in there, right?
It is in there.
I'm reading, okay.
So what we're, are we adding 100% of revenue or just 100%?
The 100% of revenue.
Oh, okay.
And just to make it clear now, in case there's any question in anybody's mind, what shooting for is that they would not pay a site fee, a location fee, nor would they pay a percentage of their revenues that they take in during the Oak Trust. Basically, it's just like it has been in many years, many years past, and this is kind of what the town attorney had told us, that we really need to change the ordinance as opposed to that contract that was going to have to be ratified after every election.
I'll second.
Any discussion? All in favor of that amendment, do so with your hand. And that,
what may your vote against? You vote against him. Sometimes y'all.
Now we're back to the motion that I made for second reading.
Yeah.
As presented.
And I wanted to make two amendments, one at a time, and just say that they probably not go anywhere, but I'm going to make it anyway. The first amendment I want to make is to this would basically add I'm going to go ahead and make the motion because I don't think it's a good second and we're going to worry about how to get in there, but anyway. I'm thinking I'm trying to amend C, which we just amended. But it would amend, the motion would be to amend. It says Lake Murray Irma Women's Club will be charged the standard application fee per booth and electrical fee per booth. So that's my motion. Is there a second?
What's that? Charge?
Will be charged the standard application fee per booth and electrical fee per booth. Is there a second?
Sir.
Really?
So any discussion? And I guess y'all figured out why, but the reason I'm doing that is I feel like they should have at least a minimum
application. What is the application fee?
Is it 200 for the?
Right now, amount this year is $200 for the group, the state.
And $100 for something.
That's like, that'll be something, but that's my reach. Any other discussion? So all in favor of being a citizen, do so a show of hands. If you're not in favor, you vote no.
Geez, you're cold.
Well, I'm just gonna make sure. So all in favor of being a dead amendment? All opposed?
Good try, Mark.
Well, next. Second one is...
Second?
Well, I haven't made it yet.
Oh, okay.
This is what we talked about last time, the Lake Murray Thermal Boom Stuff, we have to be allowed only one free boot and one free electrical charge. We'll pay for an additional boot application fee and electrical fee if applicable. So that's my motion there.
Is that that one again?
The Lake Murray Thermal Women's Club will be allowed only one free boot and one free electrical charge, period. We'll pay for additional boot application fee and electrical charge if applicable.
Second.
So, any discussion? And I think it's self-explanatory. They're not going to pay to get one free, but that's the only thing after that, they pay. Any other discussion?
I thought we, go ahead, was it my turn?
Yes.
I thought we last, when we were passing this out, we have a different site setup now, as opposed to what we had in the past, where you had a 10 by 10 spot, and if you wanted a double spot, you're gonna get two 10 by 10 spots. But since we're in a new park, and it's more of a, maybe going between trees, and the trees are not exactly 10 by 10, we let them select a spot that they want, which is right up front, and they select that spot. Now that spot is, I don't know how big it is, 20 by 20 or whatever it is, it's their spot. If they want an additional spot, another location, which would be highly unlikely if they decided they wanted one, I thought we agreed that we didn't need to worry about the fees on that. So they're the only ones selling okra at the festival, right? So I thought we already agreed that that would be a permissible.
According to the one we've already done, it would be. That's what I'm making a bigger to say we have to pay after we get the first one through.
Well, what I'm saying is I think we already, it's not applicable as far as having a 10 by 10 spot anymore. This is a site. The site as far as selected because of the topography of the park.
I think item D kind of addresses that. In fact, we didn't call it a site anymore. We called it a location.
Right.
If they had an additional location, I would, my educated guess would be that it would be because the commission had asked them to open up another location somewhere else in the park away from that location to put possibly okra at two ends. Mm-hmm. And I can only think back when we used to be on Lake Murray Boulevard. That's kind of how the multiple locations came about. They were asked to put something up close to CBS as well as something right down next to the grandstand. And if they were asked to do that, then they weren't charged for that because it was a convenience to the commission.
You were able to come in one area for...
Right, or the folks up on the other end not being able or having to walk that great distance in order to get over.
Any more discussion? All in favor then of Amendment 2, do so a show of hands. All opposed? And one more, just real short and sweet.
So
make the meeting?
Yeah.
One. So we, anyway.
I think it's clear, but I know you love to make amendments, so go ahead.
No, I just, I like to make things clear so there's not a discussion second or third or fourth attempt on the same thing. So we got a motion, you get a second on that one? If you think that's a second. So any more discussion?
This is what we're discussing, one.
Yeah, changing A to one.
As opposed to A.
Allow one vote to say A.
Okay, good. I'm going to miss all my TV shows.
We're ready to vote. All in favor then of this amendment, do so, show of hands. Oh, see, they're gone. All opposed. But now I understood it to mean one.
It is one.
Okay, have we voted on the actual order?
No, that was all the amendments that I had. Has anybody else had an amendment?
What?
Well, I wouldn't.
All right. Go right ahead.
I mean, I get second, but I'm going to get anyway. This is amendment F. And what I'm going with this one is, for some strange reason that we don't have an orchestra commission anymore, then this whole agreement basically goes out the window with that commission. And my engineer would say that we don't, for some strange reason, we disband or we do away with the orchestra commission. But this contract is gone away also. This agreement is gone.
Well, how do you want to word that?
How do I word that?
You got that to help?
Well, this would be an ordinance, so.
This is an ordinance.
It's on the books until we get rid of it.
And if they, because the orchestra commission is, correct me if I'm wrong, Captain, if the orchestra commission is cited by ordinance, in order to do away with it, you'd have to change the ordinance.
That's right.
And once the ordinance was changed, then we would have to look at any other ordinance that was affected by that change.
That's right.
If we overlook that, I would think that it would be called in codification, would it not?
I don't know the answer to that.
When they codified the changes, they would probably come back and say, hey, you deemed this one over here, you need to do something. But anyway, it would have, they just can't decide that we're not going to have a commission. It would have to be a change in the ordinance, three readings, public hearing.
We're going to do that. What I'm saying, if we do that, do three readings and get rid of the commission.
Then it would affect this and you would be doing this at the same time.
So this is automatically gone also?
It wouldn't be automatic.
It wouldn't be automatic, but it would be.
You'd have to vote on it and kill it.
Prudent to do it.
Well, your ordinance would delete, if you delete the commission, would have to delete each section and argument in there.
So by making it, you do it together. You do it together with that. The way I read it, what I said, now you have to have three readings to get rid of the orchestra commission. And you have to have three readings to get rid of this agreement. That's six readings.
Well, that could be done.
Together, I think.
That could be done at the same time. Wouldn't have to get.
So I want to tie the two together, is what I'm saying. I want to tie the two together.
It automatically.
It's automatically tied together in the book of ordinances.
How is that tied together? So what's the word that's tied those two together?
Look, I mean, you have to have an ordinance that has disbanded the, I mean, the ordinance doesn't have the, well, you know what, Barry might be right on that, where you have at least six readings, because you, three readings to disband the commission, and at that point, then you'd have to go in and do this one, because you no longer have the commission.
Correct.
You would have the commission along with.
You could do it on top of anything, but you're not.
No. You haven't.
Well, let's say you didn't go through three readings.
And item E also says, well, I can remember one of the rules, because we'll be allowed a voting seat on the commission. But if we don't have a commission, then that will be, and recommendations will be approved by a commission. If we didn't have one, then they will be able to recommend one.
But it's priceless.
Oh, yeah, but
You can have the struck, being it wasn't one by committee.
You can make a motion, however you want to word it, and then we can vote on it. Or, if you want to give you something by next meeting, because this is second meeting, right?
Yeah.
So at the next meeting, we could add it at that time.
And have Jake write up?
Well, couldn't you amend it? If that happens, where you disband the commission, then you just come back and make an amendment to this ordinance. And still have all the others in there, like their site and 100% of the revenue back on them.
Right.
So you don't have to make the amendments.
Sorry, all right.
What y'all are wanting to do is, if I understand it, is to pass an ordinance to disband and dissolve the Oak Struck Commission.
No.
No, what he's saying is, if we were to disband the commission, then this would automatically, because on the way side, at the same time.
But it would not.
Right now, it wouldn't because of the ordinance.
Well.
So we'd have to have something in there that says this becomes ineffective on a certain date or whatever.
That portion of the ordinance, which basically says that we had a seat on the commission, it becomes null and void because of.
We don't have a question yet. But item 1 through D or 8 through D would still be in effect.
I think so, yes. Now, in order to properly put it up, if you disbanded the Oak Struck Commission, what you want to do is to basically take that portion out of that ordinance because it wouldn't be any seat, it doesn't have a seat on.
But you do it at that time.
Yeah.
But I think what you're saying.
There's three readings though.
We really need to change that.
What you're saying, you don't want to just get rid of E, you want to get through A through D. A through, I mean, all of them. So I think you'd either have to add something in there that basically said, like you said, if by chance the Oak Struck Commission is wherever eliminated, or when all that dissolved, then this section here, whatever this is, ordinance 1504 is null and void.
Well, it still says it. I mean, the ordinance has several parts, as I've read it. But one says that they have a seat on the commission, and another section says that apparently, that we're passing, says that they get three other sections. Those are the two side sections. As long as you have an ordinance on the book that says if you have an Oak Struck, they get to have free sales, then they get to have free sales. Regardless whether there's an Oak Struck commission or not.
I mean, it's probably unlikely, though, Jake, if we don't have a commission, we won't have an Oak Struck.
I don't know.
Unless we have another management.
Basically, if you're going to have an Oak Struck, it's either going to happen by itself or somebody's going to make it happen.
This is the ordinance that's tying the women's club to the town of Irma, not to any other outside entity that may come after the Oak Struck Commission if they pick it up.
This ordinance basically says, I think the way it's worded is that regardless who's running the Oak Struck, they get to sell local for free.
Right.
That's okay.
Well, that's our town ordinance, but if somebody else to rent it,
right,
then that would be up to them to
negotiate with them in the yard.
Well, you know, obviously, let's assume that you basically have an independent 501c3 doing it, or let's assume you have the Chamber of Commerce doing it.
Right.
You would not be able to dictate by way of ordinance that the Chamber of Commerce would have to give them a spot free.
Yeah, well, we'll
you
them
would
them
be.
Books.
Before you gave it to them, I'm sure you have stipulations.
That would be part of a contract. You basically have to resolve.
As long as the town retains ownership, which they have, as we speak, then we would have control.
And of course, that's the only way you could dictate that they sell free okra, unless you gave it to somebody else to meet the contract.
They're going to sell free okra?
Have a free place to sell.
Oh, good. We can come get free okra now. Well, I would say either figure out something real quick or get him to come up with something on next meeting, and then we can add a F to it if you want to.
I'm just trying to be as clean as possible. If we, for whatever reason, if we somehow, if we
If that happened, you would want them to come back and change the ordinance. I don't see it.
But that takes three readings, is what I'm saying, Jay. That takes three readings to change the ordinance, first of all, to get rid of the commission. And then it'll take an additional three readings to change this ordinance.
Again, you could change them both at the same time if you want to. Nothing wrong with that. What you really need to do is this, figure out what it is you want to say, and we could help you say it. But the question is, if the town is going to still run the orchestra in some form or fashion, whether through a commission or itself, there is nothing wrong with leaving the language alone that says the women's club gets to sell over for free. Now, the town.
I'm not debating that. I agree with that 100%. I'm not debating that at all. I agree with that language. All I'm saying is that if by some chance we don't have an orchestra commission anymore, I don't think you can tie the women's club contract or the women's club ordinance to any potential new person who wants to have a festival in town hall dedicated to the orchestra.
I don't think you are.
Yeah.
You're not with what the.
Yeah, it's not your thing. Took it over, whatever way we do that, whether it's by contract selling it or whether it's by remembering.
Well, they'll call it annual orchestra festival, I guess.
We get back to the women's club and the name of whoever they want to do, whatever. Our ordinance would be basically ineffective because.
That's right.
We could just say eliminate all the ordinance and do the orchestra because we have somebody else.
That's right.
Then they do it as they do. So.
But I'm assuming, you know, looking at the rest of the agenda tonight, that we're going to keep it up the truck because somebody is going, somebody is going for a commission. It happens to be somebody I know and respect. But I don't know. If you're going to dissolve the, if you dissolve the orchestra commission, we probably ought to take a look at the other code sections involved and make recommendations of what should be modified and what shouldn't. But if you're not going to dissolve it, I think you're talking about not a problem.
So, do you want to make a, or do you just want to wait till the next meeting and?
No, I'm just, I don't know if I get a second on it. I mean.
Well, word it how you want to, and Kim can start there.
I don't want words to.
Or we can just let Jacob you out of something next time and do it on the third meeting.
That's the way we get the change in the revenue.
You understand where I'm going with this?
Mm-hmm. I understand where you're going.
Okay,
I'm not sure why you're going, but I understand where you're going.
Okay, well, I'm thinking about it about
dissolve
the commission.
I'm ready to vote on the motion.
Okay. All right, well, we have got A, B, C, D, E with the amendment. 100% of revenue, as it's written on this page here. Any other discussion? All in favor then of 1504, as amended with 100%, do so with show of hands. And opposed. Next item is approval of contract with the band in Tokyo Show for the orchestra. Festival in the amount of $7,500. Is there a motion for approval?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
Any discussion?
This contract for $3,500, is the town paying for the band or is the orchestra commission paying for the band?
It would be coming out of the extra fund, out of the extra budget.
We haven't approved our budget, so Yes, that's what I'm saying, if the town were to be $3,500.
Spend $2,500, down payment, but come September, if the $5,000 will come out of the overstripped money, which is in their budget, which is approved later on.
And the $2,500 will come out of it too, if.
It'll be this year's budget for them.
Right, with them, their budget, that still comes out this year, not next year.
Yeah.
I'm really doubting about the budget.
Yeah.
That's come out of there.
So you agree that you can do it without having a budget place?
Correct, it's down payment, that's right.
This is for the new budget, not in July.
And this is the same thing we do every year for them, when they have to get a contract approved, and they have to come.
Normally the town would pay for the band, I mean, this would be last year.
That's what we're doing this year.
No, you say you came out of overstripped money?
No.
The town did it for everything, it's just no.
This is for everything, yeah. This budget, if that's what you're telling me, doesn't go into effect until July.
Right, but the town paid for the band last year.
The town's gonna pay for it this year too? And it?
So then.
We'll be paying for it out there.
Okay, so.
Yeah, but they still.
My point is then, if the town's gonna pay for the band, right, then why are you tying it to their budget? Why are you making them pay that?
They're not.
It's a play on words here now.
I'm just saying, what I'm saying.
The town is going to forward the deposit from the overstripped budget and overstripped funds. So the overstripped will be paid 100%.
So any more discussion? All in favor then of the approval of the contract with the band Tokyo Joe, do so with show of hands. All opposed? Next is the appointment of the orchestra coordinator for 2015 festival, and she's coming out, we recognize you.
We all know that Bob's been handling in this all along, but everybody's making a big deal that we have to give him a title. And I'm in favor of that, I think we ought to name him the coordinator. And in addition, if the overstripped commission comes up with an administrator's name, I understand they have to interview six or seven, I mean, there's more than, why, six or seven people, and I've looked at some of the resumes, and they need to interview them well, because these are well-qualified people, I believe. But anyway, in the event they do, I think whoever is selected should maybe shadow Bob and him for the month of August and September, so they'll be on the ground running when they take over October, November. Does that make sense?
Well, I mean, right now, we're appointing, are you saying Bob for the?
Bob, yeah, the coordinator. Not administrator, coordinator. Overstripped for this year. And it's a terminal thing, and I think Bob likes it, terminal.
Well, I mean, if we appoint somebody to the coordinator, we may not need an administrator, but if there's somebody that.
If there's somebody really good that comes up.
Then they can still, we can still put that on the agenda at a later date. The only thing I would say is, a later date's gonna be end of this month, and then you're down to three or four months. So I don't know, but they could, council could put another one on the thing.
Well, if you would just be on the job training for the next person, which I think is a good idea. Bob's doing a good job.
Hope that whoever that person is, if they do select someone, would be qualified to do it. From day one, I'll say that in here, but I think, so we can probably even tweak this kind of, put off the culture here, going here. So I don't know, I would guess that you would just be too, I don't know.
What's the difference between a coordinator and administrator?
He didn't want the title administrator, because that comes from the.
No,
think we ought to make Bob coordinator so he can continue to handle things. It's going as smoothly as it can go, and I think we ought to let him finish. But if the commission comes up with somebody, I think it would be excellent to let him train with Bob.
So this person that they come up with, would you like the co-administrator or quasi-administrator or administrator, no title or no title?
Just for 2 or 3 months. No, but...
I mean, it's confusing. I mean, either he's the administrator or he's not. If he's coordinating it, I mean, he's doing it now, I'm saying, right?
He's running it right now. And I think we ought to let him run it until this one is over. But if the Oversight Commission chooses an administrator, I don't see why he couldn't work with Bob for 2 months to learn how the town does things and then take over. I think that's the best solution. I'd rather than throw somebody in the water that may or may not know how to swim, throw on a life jacket first.
Yeah, but hopefully we ain't gonna hire, they wouldn't take somebody or shoot somebody that can't swim, you know, throw in water.
But you don't, events coordinator, maybe somebody planning weddings and funerals and baptisms. And this is baptism by fire.
Yeah, but now you're micromanaging the Oversight.
No, I'm not. I'm offering the, no.
If you tell them that they can hire somebody, we don't trust them, we have to shadow Bob for 6 months or 3 months or whatever. Why have an administrator at all if he's got a call in? Why go?
Because evidently they want one, and that is fine.
They want one by ordinance. I mean, that's the...
Okay, Barry. They may not know business about running an Oversight. How do you know? I don't know. Things are in place now, and it's going fine. I keep hearing this thing that so everybody needs a title. Okay, Bob's title is coordinator. If they come up with an administrator and if we approve it or make it whatever, then let him learn.
Well, what does the coordinator do?
I can guarantee you the administrator does not know the town's way of account. I can guarantee you that. And that would be a good thing for him to learn, if that's what you got to deal with.
Captain, no. You want to make him a coordinator, but he is coordinating.
He is. Yep.
He is coordinating.
Yeah.
And we give him a title called coordinator.
Yeah. Just.
And then they have a go-to guy. Then they know who to contact.
See, Kurt said he didn't know who to call. That Bob had to have a title, and we had to vote on it. I said, okay, we'll give him a title. He's doing all the work.
I'm just waiting for you to commit.
I would have finished long ago. Go ahead.
Okay. What you call bomb is irrelevant, really, at this point. I would guess that I probably have more knowledge of the overstrut and the functions of the overstrut than anybody else on council, or everyone on council combined. I cannot imagine in my wildest dreams an administrator that had not done the overstrut before, not another festival, but the overstrut, would want to step into the lion's den at this late time. Bob is doing an outstanding job. A lot of time is being spent trying to help and working with Bob and his staff. So as far as the go-to person, Bob's the go-to person. Now, if that means we need to get him a fez, a uniform, a badge, we can do that.
Well, Kirk said we had to get
The thing that I want to see is I want to see a full accounting of hours spent answering the telephone, going to the post office.
Starting when?
From the first day they started. And that should be easy to go back and figure out how many hours were spent going through records, setting up files, all of this. I want to see all of that at the end. Because if there was no time spent doing that, then we don't need an administrator. It will just poof happen. If it doesn't poof happen, that means that a lot of time was spent. And if we can spend enormous amounts of time in town hall doing this, that means we have people in town hall we don't need, because they had nothing else to do. So I want to see an accounting of what we have spent as far as time allocation. Bob and them were doing an outstanding job, and it's not just Bob. I mean, Kathleen's working. I know Kim's working. Everybody's pitching in. And it's lots of hours. And it's going to be some late hours come July and August.
Yeah. Kim, can you do that?
Well, Bob's been, I think,
most of the time.
And I think it'd be good there, because it'd be glad it's not in a year.
Exactly.
A good compensation for whoever does this in the future.
You know, I've asked the question, how's things going? Are we getting 10, 15 phone calls a day? When do you get 50 phone calls and the answering machine says that it's full and can't take any more, and you're trying to get those first 50 off to get to the next one?
Well, then you and I are going over there, aren't we? We're going.
Very possibly will.
Well.
But again, that means that town hall can't do it alone.
Yeah.
That's the point I'm trying to make. It's so that we know it's not someone's opinion.
Okay.
But I have no problem calling Bob, coordinator, Poupon, getting a fez, a uniform, or whatever. He's doing a damn good job.
He is.
For fez.
But the designer's wear.
Oh. With the horns in it? That's for a fleece, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. He's from that very well.
You say Hardy or Harvey?
Harvey.
I don't get credit.
But more or less, you're saying, you know, let it ride like this.
Yeah. I can't imagine somebody was going to step off the gangplank right now.
So, any more discussion? All in favor then of the appointment of overstrut coordinator, as Bob Brown is the overstrut coordinator.
Well,
for 2000.
I want to make a little coordinator, that's what's called interim administrator.
Well, I think if you do that, I don't think there's anything in the ordinance or town code now that identifies a coordinator as it relates to the open trust.
Right.
However, we have already amended the ordinance to identify an administrator and have clear black and white duties, of which I don't think that Bob is going to have time to do 100%. One of those being fundraising. And I don't want him to come back and have somebody use that as a hammer and try to beat Bob up because he didn't do fundraising when it says right there in the code, you got to do it. I don't think that's fair to him.
No.
Not at this late time. He stepped up without balking, trying to make this thing work. That don't cut him off at the knees.
Coordinator's good one.
Yeah, I think it's a safe.
So when somebody asks who's administrator, you don't have one.
Bob's the coordinator. All he needs to go to guy. He will do it or he will cause it to be done.
So then what's
that plan?
So what is it, what is the commission do with that? Somebody named for administrator?
I think that they are after they interview on the 11th.
And then I heard today that there could be late resumes coming in. And I don't know.
I haven't heard a word since the meeting.
I mean, there could be
Monday
a dozen or so people on this job. It ain't me, but you know how I work.
Yeah, I've heard that they had. I've only seen one resume.
So. You ready to vote on your question?
I sent you one.
Yeah, that's the only one I've seen.
All in favor then, if your appointment is Bob Brown as your coordinator 2015 festival, do so with your pen. All opposed?
Mr. Walker opposed. I'll strike for a second.
Next item is first reading of ordinance 1505. To amend the town code, Article 4, Board Commission, Committee, Division 2, Obstruct Commission, Section 265, Finance and Expenditures. And, Kathy, well, first, is there a motion? And I'll let you read that, and then that section, and we'll get into it.
I have something.
And, is there a second?
Sure.
Go ahead and read that, Kathy, so everybody knows it.
Okay, this is the ordinance about, I'm not going to read those top two paragraphs.
No, just the
about finances and expenditures, and this is what I'm going to remove, and then I'm going to tell you why I'm going to remove. The Urbo Open Trust Commission shall have control over the expenditure of funds raised by or appropriated to the Open Trust Commission for the expenses incurred in the performance of the duties and functions. Okay, that is fine. That was written in 1985. And now we're in 2015 where we have transparency and where we have people accountable either by job or by election for all the money. And this is a lot of money. This is not anything to sneeze at, but this is a lot of money. I was at the meeting Monday night looking at those lovely group of ladies who get paid nothing and who are very well taking care of the open front and doing their jobs and all that, and I thought, we can't make these ladies responsible for all this money. I mean, that's not their job. They
who's
need
who's
to...
Who's offered them?
The commission.
Kurt Luther's that lady.
I wasn't talking to him. I'm talking about the ladies actually doing the work. So anyway, all I could think of was, this was a disservice to them. We're going to write a check for whatever they need, but we're responsible. Or Bob's responsible. I mean, there's a limited number of people that has to be responsible because we can be unelected or we can be fired. They can't. And I think it's too much to ask of them. And I think they would tell you the same thing if they read this. I believe they would. And I don't
responsibility, the money should be ours. And I think we're being derelict in our duties and our oath if we don't accept the responsibility of it and take it, not let them worry with it. Whatever they want, we've always signed. And I just think it would be in their best interest and the town's best interest. Because then if somebody agrees or disagrees with us, they yell at us from the audience. I don't want those ladies yelling at us. I'd rather have us, we're used to it. So, you know, I want them to be appreciated. But the responsibility of the money is ours. And that's what I believe. That's why I wanted that two lines taken out.
Any more discussion?
If you say the responsibility of the money is ours, then I'm confused on that statement.
The responsibility of maintaining the money, paying the bills, doing everything regarding the money is ours.
Okay, and the Open Shore Commission does not spend money that's not, you know, it's not verified through the town hall. So
yeah, they could do.
Yeah, well, they could.
Like what?
Well, last year they overspent their budget by, I don't know, 30 to 50 thousand, so that is an issue.
They're not sticking within their budget.
I go back to the original, because you're involved in public money, and that's our responsibility.
I understand that, but you keep saying it's our responsibility, and it always has been our responsibility. It always has been.
This says it's not.
We're the ones that signed the check.
We are.
We signed a check based on the invoice that's given to us. We don't have any control over that invoice, and if they give us an invoice, I understand it, we're obligated to pay.
We can't say no if we get the invoice back.
We can't say no to the invoice.
I don't know anything we haven't signed. I'm waiting to pay for everything.
That's part of the problem is, I don't know what is all in the budget without looking at it, but let's just say, well, like I say, this band, let's say $500. That's, I know it's in this budget, but it's in the Open Shore budget for $7,500. If they decided to pay $9,500, then they were overspending the $7,500 in that line item. And I think there's, and I've heard Kurt make that comment too, they have control. And they do, because right now they have control over the expenditure of funds, but it says raised or appropriate. Anything not raised or appropriate, they don't have no control
that's
over it.
That's public funds, but they don't have it. No one should have.
When you spend more than allocated, then you spent more than what was raised or appropriate.
I think this is the right thing to do, since we have town money, overstruck money, all kinds of money. This is the right way to do it. It's our responsibility, not theirs. They just put on a festival. We pay for it.
Still, there has to be some way of whenever they're going to authorized expenses, whatever they may be, somehow or another they need to know if you can do this amount for that, or that amount for that, or that amount for that, or whatever.
Well, they did their budget.
Hmm?
They did their budget.
If they did it, but if they take the budget, we pass it, and it goes in the wayside, and they never look at it throughout the year, and they keep overspending in a year, instead of having revenues of $100,000 and expenses of $100,000. You have revenues of $100,000 and expenses of $150,000 or $120,000 or $110,000. You gotta stay within the budget throughout the year. And evidently that's not gonna happen because we have deficit there. How to correct that? Either maybe one would be this way or one would be another way, I'm not sure. But I think it is an issue of not staying in the raised or appropriated funds. I gotta stay within
this is for their protection as much as anything. And nobody is responsible for the money but us.
And even if we take this completely out, somehow or another they, you know, whatever we approve on the budget, they have to still stay within that.
Point of order. Was there a motion to your excuse me, a second to your motion?
Yes, Mr. Watt.
Yeah, they were there. Yeah.
He seconds everything. Am I clear, Derek? You understand what? Okay, because it handled
all money, not just Oakland's money, but town money. It's our responsibility. We should put these on this lady, or even Kirk.
Well, but they still have to.
Well, it's their, they can tell us how to spend it, yeah.
But they still have to stay within that bounds if they send.
Well, they have to do that, whether.
Or Tim an invoice.
Whether we do this or not.
Yeah, but that's not what happened.
Oh, well.
Because we're getting invoices and we're paying them, but in a year, the expenses are over the budget expenses.
What invoice did you get this over the mountain?
You can look at all the stuff through.
Specifically, one example.
All right, well, let me see if I can find his thing from last year.
You keep saying that, and I don't believe there's an example of anything like that.
Now, this is something that was presented, this right one, that they gave, is this the one they gave you all?
Yes.
$7,000. Well, this don't show what they were budgeting last year. But they have revenue expenses last year according to their, $174,000, they have revenue of $116,000. Now, without looking at their line item, well, that's on their plan of later, we have to look at that and see.
That's my point, it's not, you can't look at revenue like that, that includes revenue from vendors and stuff, which is not real revenue, it's just.
Well, and they may have it on this whole thing that you print out.
You have an overstruck budget?
Yeah, it shows.
It shows last year's.
Actual.
For the last couple of years, it works.
Well, it just shows the actual, that shows what it's been. Now, it shows the current budget, but it only shows year-to-date actual, so that's really not enough to take from you. Say like,
What do you mean by it's not up to date?
Well, like under the 2014-15 current budget, corporate sponsorship group, there's 35.3 budgeted, there's 20,900 today. But we don't know if there's any money to meet.
Normally, it's not.
Okay, how did they spend? Which line did they spend more than those? Here you had booth rentals of 15,000 budgeted, and they spent 12,000. How did they only spend that booth rental?
Well,
I'm talking about last year.
Yeah.
And that's the kind of example as you're saying. Overspend what they were budgeting.
This sheet here that shows what they proposed, and then you have to look at the actual and see.
Right, it's right here. It's right here on the budget. The current 2014-2015. So my point is that there's no example of what you're saying.
Well, there is. I'm just not got it in because I haven't. All I've looked at is bottom line.
Well, you can't look at the bottom line because the bottom line includes revenue from sources that we don't use as revenue. I mean, you made a statement that we that the Orchestra Commission, and this is another good point, is the Orchestra Commission is not sticking to their budget. They're spending more than what the budget.
Right.
And I'm saying on this budget that I see in front of us from last year, I don't see where they've done that. I don't see any line item that's more than what they had.
Again, what I'm saying is, in order to do that, you'd have to have this sheet right here that they come to us for 2014 proposed, and then you can compare it to 2014 actual. I don't believe.
No, what are you doing?
Yeah, you got it right here.
It's right here.
See these numbers in parentheses? That's over budget.
Yeah, we're looking at you.
But now that's.
The last page and the numbers that are in parentheses.
That sheet right there runs from June to July to June. It's not the same as the one they gave us. It runs from December to December, January.
But that's including the ticket, the boot ticket sales. That's included in the numbers. You can't really use it as an over budget statement.
Well, a lot of it is not that far beyond their control, but we understand that.
But you're making a statement that these people are spending more.
I said
the mayor made a statement that they're spending more than they're being budgeted. I'm saying that's not the case.
Yeah, Mary, if you'll go on that first page, it's right there.
Well, it says the budget on the third page that they.
they budgeted $162,600, and their actual expenses was $155,713. They spent less than they budgeted.
Exactly.
What about?
May I make a suggestion?
This revenue over and under expenditure, two lines down, that's got the parentheses around the numbers.
Well, that's because they didn't generate the revenue.
I understand.
That they were gonna rip, there's no generate.
And I'm not complaining about it. This is my argument. My argument is we're responsible.
May I make a suggestion?
Yes.
They have to present us with a budget. We have to approve their budget. It goes into the town's budget. It's part of the overall budget. Instead of removing that statement, the Irma Orchestra Commission shall have control over the expenditure of funds raised or appropriated to the Orchestra Trust Commission for its expenses incurred in the performance of its duties and functions within the parameters of its budget. Just after the word function, take off the period and say within the parameters of its budget.
Okay. Before you go on to that.
Period.
We still have here raised by or appropriated to the Orchestra. Now, that's from the town.
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily, but it usually is. Part of it is anyway. That's the problem.
How much did the town? Ask you a specific question now. Mm-hmm. How much did the town give the Orchestra last year in dollars?
What was it?
About 21? Not all money?
That's what I'm looking for.
Yeah, that would have been, that was appropriated to the Orchestra, the town.
That's public.
That's public money.
And that's.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
About $14,000. They have one sponsor that gave them $15,000. That was not public money.
That was not public money.
And we have another sponsor that gave them, I know, $3,000. That was not public money. That's money that's appropriated to the Orchestra. Okay? So, that's dealt with your point of order there. Now, the Orchestra, in order to operate, has got to have the flexibility to make decisions without having to come back to this council and have them micromanage. Example, and if they have in their budget to clean up the street sweeper, to clean up, they should have the, and if they have an amount in their budget for that, they should not have to come back to this council and say, can we please go ahead and contract with the street sweeper to clean up the festival site? If the money is within our budget, it's just like your budget at home. If it's in the budget, you don't have to go back and contact somebody to see if you can check out at the grocery store.
No, it's not.
And to carry it a step further, it is all public money. It is town money, and it is 100% controlled by the town.
To an extent.
Name the exception to the extent.
Well, they can spend money and invoice the town, and we got to pay, so we're not in control.
Right, and if that invoice is within their budget.
Even if it's over the budget, you've got to pay it.
Yeah, but if it's within its budget, they're okay. And that's the point I'm asking here, is those last few words is to say it has to be within the budget. Now, the town has a budget, and Bob is obligated to stay within that budget. If he wants to vary from that, he comes to council. and says, hey, we've got to have a new widget. And it's going to cost, but we don't even have it in the budget. And council makes a decision. It's public money, it's transparent. That's all I'm asking that the Ocean Truck be allowed to do, to stay within their budget. If all of a sudden they have $1,000, and I'm going to use some numbers just out of the air, $1,000 for a street sweeper to police the area, and he comes up and says, well, it's going to cost $1,400. Then they may have to come to council and say, look, we can't get it $1,000 anymore. But if he says, I'll do it for $800, they should be able to say, go ahead and put us on the books.
And
what you're asking is to take that out so that they don't have that authority to even go and buy a roll of stamps.
No.
That's what you've done if you take that out.
Well, if it, I mean, what it says right now is the Ocean Truck Commission shall have control over expenditure of funds raised and appropriated by the Ocean Truck Commission.
Mm-hmm.
Which, right now, to me,
it's only controlled by their budget.
But all their funds are raised and appropriated by them.
Exactly.
And that, I think, is the problem, even if we add another clause in there, which I think that clause is good. It doesn't, I mean, unless, and I'll just say the chairman or somebody has to be responsible to say, whenever they're deciding on the street sweeper, who knows what, is what is the budget? $1,000?
I don't disagree with you at all.
And that's where we're missing the boat somehow. And I don't know, and I hate to say this in this kind of way, but I mean, here from county, I've seen some things down there where when they do something like that, everybody has to sign off. And I don't say everybody here, but it may be that if they're going to vote on whatever they're going to vote on, then they sign off on a form too that says, we're going to begin the vote this $1,500 for this, and we're voting on this, and we're voting to spend $1,500. And maybe that moment they realize, okay, but, well, the budget is this, and we can't go over it.
Right, but also, this gives them the power, you may not like that word, but it gives them the power to say, well, there's no way we can not have a street sweeper. We're going to go ahead and commit $1,400. And we're going to take $400 out of radio advertising and move it over to street sweeping. That's what council does all the time. We move funds. But again, like you said, you're looking at bottom line. The bottom line is they're not overspending their budget. And it's just that. It is a budget.
I've got the information from like four Ocean Trucks. Some of them, they haven't overspent their budget because they didn't need to get the revenue, and that's what's wrong.
Right.
Some of it is they overspent their expenses that were budgeted too, so there's a combination. Sometimes they overspent what they had budgeted in expenses, and sometimes they didn't get the revenue.
That's a moving target. It's the same thing with the town. Sometimes we spend it and we get the tax dollars in. Other times, our tax shared revenue is a little down and the insurance goes up. But we move money to make it balance at the end of the year. All I'm saying is tie them to their budget. If they have a budget of $100,000, and they come up with somebody that's willing to write them a check for another $50,000, they got more money they can spend. Get a bigger man. But because of the size of that expenditure, it may have to come to council because they have a spending limit, just like Bob has a spending limit.
And most of the department heads have a.
But if you take that out, you have eliminated their spending limit. And they would, by right, have to come to this
Well, right now we got this on the table to remove it, or,
Let's see the call for the question. Do I say it?
Well, a motion on the table.
You got a motion on the table to remove it. Offered an amendment to it.
Yeah, but you would be making an offer to amend something we're gonna remove, so we have to,
You have to take up the amendment first.
Yeah. But once we take it up and vote on it to remove it or not remove it, then it's done.
Well, we can amend it next week.
Well, you could amend it to not remove it, and then add section blah, blah, blah.
Right.
And then see if it gets a second, and then discuss that, and then if not, then we'll be back and vote on to remove it.
Right.
Okay, so what are we doing?
Well, right now we're either gonna vote on removing it or not removing it, and let us,
Okay.
To make an amendment to not remove it from the ordinance, and then add section, and then that, that.
I'll be glad to make the.
You want to add section?
Right.
And add that, whatever. So, what's your amendment?
Madam Clerk.
To add at the end of the word functions, within the parameter of this budget.
Within the parameter of their budget. Meaning if they spend it, it's gotta be in the budget.
But the word remove would not be there.
No, the word remove would not be.
No, he would amend it to remove that word remove too, so that part of his amendment is just remove.
To remove the word.
Remove.
Remove.
No, it, yeah.
And then add this here.
Add.
And.
That's a lot of responsibility, and I want to realize it.
Is there a second?
Second.
Now, any discussion about that?
Amendment?
Yeah. Right now, we're not removing it, we're changing it. The only thing I would say, and I would ask, and I don't know what is the best route to do this, but just putting it on paper, so to speak, doesn't make it happen. Somehow or another, the commission has to make sure they stay within the parameters of their budget for what's raised and appropriate.
And I think that would be an absolute requirement of the administrator. And
really,
when.
The chairman, because to me, we appoint the chairman and, well, we appoint the commission and the commission appoint the chairman and they kind of step into the role.
Well.
Somebody over there needs to.
Okay, I know we're getting off here about something that's on the table that needs to be voted on, but I have some strong feelings along those lines that I would like to address.
About that?
The chairman, the administrator, and council.
Is it have to do with this, or would it be better one?
I think it'd be better to take this up first and then come back to that.
Okay. Go ahead.
So if a donation came in to the town of them, it would be up to us whether or not we gave it to them.
Not necessarily.
We always give it to them.
I know we always.
They give it to them.
But if a donation comes in to the town of Irmo, it is up to us to decide that.
No, if I give the donation.
Well.
No, I would disagree with that, I'm saying.
I mean, technically, if I give you money, it's yours to do with whatever you want to do.
I want to do.
Even if I tell you, I want this money to go here, once it's in your hands.
I can give you a private back.
Or you might not, but I think, yeah, you, I mean.
I'll give you a good example. Palmetto Health, Park Ridge, gives us a big chunk of money divided up into smaller payments annually. for the naming right to the amphitheater. That money comes into the town, it's not given to the Oaks Trust. Okay? They won't control it, the Oaks Trust. They want their name right up there. They want to be a part of the Oaks Trust, but that money's not given to the Oaks Trust. Nowhere is it ever shown in the Oaks Trust budget. But if Joe's dry cleaning says, here's $1,000 for the Oaks Trust, my grandchildren just love that place. Love those rides. Here's $1,000. And they give it to us. It would come through the town. It would have to, because the Oaks Trust does not handle money. Okay?
I hear what they do.
No, they don't. The money comes through town. But I think the town would be obligated to put that money into the Oaks Trust fund. You would be derelict in your duty if you didn't. It's just like the alcohol funds. They don't have to go to Oaks Trust, but they cannot go to repair potholes in the roads either.
But Harvey, you cannot say the Oaks Trust does not handle money. They handle a great deal of money.
Well, I think it depends on how you, and I don't want to go to what the meaning of is, but...
No, I don't either.
But handling money...
I'm not talking about physically handling money, but they're
responsible.
There is money that comes through in the form...
And I think every one of you shirking your responsibility by not accepting this responsibility. Because I think it's ours to accept. They can spend... I'm going to hush because I can't make these people do right. I can't. But I can go on record. My mother would not have let me play with these children when I was little. I can tell you that. Maybe you, Jake.
I would have been happy. So any more discussion on the amendment, which we're all right now? So, we're ready to vote on the amendment?
Have we amended?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've removed, and we've added the...
Within the parameters.
Within the parameters of their budget.
All right, all in favor then of the amendment, do so with show of hands. All opposed?
It's our responsibility, not theirs.
So now this amendment. So any more discussion? Are we ready to vote on the ordinance change? Which is as amended.
It's going to be two to four. We just voted on the amendment to pass.
Okay, we go about it.
Oh, okay.
So all in favor then of ordinance 1505 as amended, do so with show of hands.
Third voice.
All opposed?
3-2.
Boy,
all right.
We shirk our responsibility.
The next item is first reading of ordinance 1506 to amend the Hermo Town Code, Article 4, Board of Commissioners Meeting, Division 2. Oaks Commission section 62 membership, and I'll make a motion for that since I put it on the table.
What is it? Or the what?
1506. It should be right there.
Okay, I got it.
Is there a second?
What am I second?
Sorry, Mr. Mayor, I'm just trying to pull it up.
Yeah, me too.
It was kind of out of order on the page.
So is there a second?
Second.
Oh.
I read it.
Okay. Any discussion? I'll says, for all the people out there, basically we're deleting section D of the ordinance that we just passed last month, I guess it was. Deleting section D, second sentence, I think it was. That basically says a fair and equitable compensation will be recommended by the Upstate Commission and approved by the majority of council. And adding, and basically switching that to say town council shall approve by majority vote an annual contract with the individual name and or company, including compensation paid schedule. The selection process, including solicitation, will be in accordance with the accepted purchasing policy as outlined in the town code. Basically, what that says is what I was trying to do was get rid of that sentence and then make it more, in my mind, more clear. It just said council will approve whatever contract we have for the administrator, whenever we get one, whatever. They will approve an annual contract, so it'll be an annual thing, with an individual name or company, and we'd also include the compensation in paper, because what happens is $1,000 on the way of time. You get money right now, and all of them kind of terrible good payment. And then the selection process is in accordance with whatever our regular purchasing policy says. It's under whatever dollar amount, which would go by there. It's over whatever dollar amount, which would go by there. And that way, if it turns out at the end of the year, and if Bob says, this job needs X amount of dollars a year to compensate somebody, even though it's because it needs this and that, then we can kind of go from there. But to me, that better clarify us then. And so that's why I need to attend. And Kathy, you want to do that?
I think that's clearer, and that's the first time I've read it. I guess I didn't read all that stuff ahead of that, but that, and especially that it's in accordance with accepted purchasing policies outlined in the town code. Yeah, that's the way we ought to do it.
Attorney Moore?
Yep. I agree with what he said. I think that if you add it to the front end of this, upon the recommendation of the Overstruck Commission, town council shall approve by majority the rest of it. Basically, what I'm saying is that the commission should make a recommendation, just like they're going to do. Hopefully now, they're going to interview and they're going to come back with somebody that they feel like they can work with. Okay? And it's, we've always asked them for their recommendation. Kathy, you said tonight, we're going to do what they ask us to do.
We always do.
We always do, and I'm asking just to put that in there, that we will ask them for their recommendation. I think that if they recommended someone to us that was out on free release from the Iron Bar Hilton, then council would have a right to say, hey, we don't agree with that. But the rest of this is what we have always done with, you know, putting Bob puts out the RFP. He kind of knows what we need, he puts it in there, and makes sure that we abide by the state procurement code based on dollars and cents and parameters. I'm just saying, let's ask for the Overstruck Commission's recommendation. But other than that, I agree wholeheartedly, and I want to go a step further after this.
Well, it says it in the sentence that I'm deleting, so you kind of get rid of that when you delete it.
But in the whole ordinance, doesn't it say that? That they are the selective?
Well, it did right here.
Yeah.
But you're taking that out now.
Yeah.
No, not that sentence. I think it says further up that the person is recommended by the Overstruck Commission, and then this other, so I'm not sure of that. I just,
I think so. But one thing we need to, yeah, one thing we need to, let's say, clarify, or agree upon, I guess is a better word. I just remembered, I was trying to find that previous one, but you had all four, and I thought it was kind of a good idea.
It's in the 3:17:15 packet.
I think I've got a copy of it.
Yeah, I was thinking.
Here, because I made some changes to the other one. Let me say this, I've already booked you,
It's in the 3:17.
Technically.
Packet, yeah.
Yeah.
15:02.
15:02.
Okay.
Yeah, the first sentence of that says administrator is authorized to move the contract and compensate based on qualification. So you get rid of that sentence, we get rid of the part that it's a recommendation by this court.
So you get rid of that sentence too?
No, I'm just saying, if we get rid of that sentence where it was, then we get rid of the recommendation. But we can add it like Harvey said, we can add that in there and put it back in. The only thing we need to, agree upon is technically by our ordinance, we cannot make amendments to a first reading. We just did it and voted on it. And we kind of do it here, but we,
where's that? Where is it?
It's in our town ordinance where it talks about all that, that you basically are supposed to vote on with your first reading and then make amendments second and third. I don't know if that's coming from the comment, that's what it says. What we can do, if council is in agreement, for the record, we can all agree that, yes, we know we did this, but we're okay with it, we can do it now, but then we shouldn't in the future, whatever you want to cut. Because we could come back, or somebody could come back at a date and say, we all changed it, we shouldn't, whatever. So, since we already care, and since we are here, is anyone in disagreement that we could not?
I mean, I'd go forward with it, you know, it can be put up to be ratified at the next meeting.
We'll be voting on it as amended. We'll be voting on it as amended at the next meeting anyway.
But we can ratify it prior to the vote.
I'm just, I don't know why, it just crossed my mind.
It didn't mind either,
So, we can either move forward and go ahead and make this amendment, do these two, and then from now on out, we want the rest of the night, but I don't think there's anything else up here anymore. Or we can just leave the one we just did, the one we can change it from later, or we can change it now.
We're actually not taking the whole, we're not deleting the whole sentence, just reworded it.
We're deleting the second sentence of that 2:62 and replacing with this one.
But a lot of the verbiage is the same, because even in the first one, you didn't want to recommend by the old definition.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to go ahead and do this, but unless somebody says, no, we can't do that, we're sitting up here on council, and we're not abiding by our ordinance or whatever, I'm going to go ahead and let the party want to make amendment upon recommendation of, what do you say, of the commission?
The commission.
Commonly. And we can see if we want to do that. So do you want to make that?
Yeah, I'll make that in the form of an amendment.
And is that a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor then of that amendment to add upon recommendation of Orchestrat Commission, do so short hands? Alright, and all opposed? So now we're at 2:62 with the new terminology, the new wording, and then also this addition. Any discussion on that?
The new wording.
Is upon recommendation of Oak Street.
As amended.
Yeah, as amended, with Oak Street Commission, comment, and then the other stuff. So all in favor of that 1606 as amended. Do so with your hand. That's out of the way. Next item is appointment to the.
Can I?
Yes.
Based upon this and upon your concerns and mine as well, and I think everybody on this council, if we do things right as far as spending money and making sure the orchestra spends money correctly and their budgets.
Really?
Mr. Mayor, you are charged, and I don't want to take the time to read through and find it, but I'm going to ask you to look back at the ordinance and.
The orchestra ordinance?
Orchestra ordinance. You are charged at the beginning, at the election of officers. You are charged to meet with the orchestra commission and their administrator and charge them with following state law and making sure that they do not overstep their bounds. If I'm correct, and I'm just, I'm not reading, but you're charged with doing that. And I think that that would be a very important step to dealing with some of the concerns that we all have as to whether they just go off in a scattered manner. Whoever the administrator is going to have the authority to tell the commission, you can't spend that much money on a band because you don't have that much money in your budget. And then the chairman is going to have to take that information and deal with it with the commission. Right now, there, I feel like that there's a ping pong ball out there that has administrator on it and chairman. And it's kind of thrown in a box and it bounces around. And somebody says, well, they might be overspending their budget. Well, that's the administrator's responsibility. The administrator, well, let's go talk with them. Well, no, the administrator works for the chairman. And the chairman is the one wanting to overspend or vice versa. So it needs to come back, I think, and you could do that, I think. Do you agree with me?
Yeah, and I'm going to say this too. Anybody wants to chime in at some point down the road, I'm going to look at this 264 duties and functions paragraph probably in the next couple of weeks. Spoke to Kirk too about him coming up with some, I'll say guidelines. But, and just for instance, that fundraising thing. When I read that, what it says to me is administrator will assure the collection of all required fees and implement a plan to obtain maximum sponsorship donation level grants, blah, blah, blah. If I were the administrator, I'd say, okay, here's my plan. Kirk, you go get the money. That's my plan. And then I could pass it off on him or whoever, or the group, and I'd say, okay, each one of you needs to go get $5,000 and come back and get it. That could be my plan. And I think we probably need to, I think there needs to be some clarification of the responsibility of the administrator and the chairman before we hire them, so that maybe we get rid of some of this.
I agree with you. The next step in that, and I think this may be something Bob is going to need to do with Jake, is to find out where we need to be legally with the person raising money as an individual on behalf of the town.
The government.
The government. Because the orchestra is owned solely by the government, the town. I think there's going to have to be a registration with the Secretary of State's office. And my memory is correct, and it's failing me. But that was an issue that came up with Jim Twitty, with Susan, with Jim Twitty again, and with Susan, about actually going out as a quote fundraiser and having to register with the Ethics Commission and the Secretary of State's office. So that it's not considered a scam. That doesn't mean it won't be on the Scrooge's list, you know. So, again, that's something I think we need to look at.
And I may have something on the next agenda that may take a few minutes.
Right. We've got some time now, yeah. But I did want to mention that, not putting aside your concerns or Kathy's or anybody, but there comes a time and a place that we need to do that.
Next item is appointment to the Oak Truck Commission. And I know Mr. Walker asked me to be on here. I'll let him start. And basically, we had an individual step down from the last meeting. And so there's a voting seat, if I'm correct, a voting seat available. So it was equal voting seat. Any council member can make a recommendation, make an appointment, whatever. So we'll get started.
We originally put the name Jerome Tyler out there before for a voting seat on the Stroke Commission, and that's when we put forward a voting member and a little more seats. But then since then, Kim Oliver has resigned, so that opened up the seat for Mr. Tyler, and I'm sure he still wants to do it. He wants to be an active member on this commission and put forth his name for commission.
Any other names?
Yes. Put forth the name of Kathy Bat Little, who works for the federal court, is that correct?
Parker Evans' daughter.
Yes. Say that again, Kathy, what's her name?
Kathy what?
E-V-A-T-T, last name Little.
It's, that's actually just Evan.
What? I just wanted her name. E-V-E-T-T, E-V-A-T-T, A-T-T. She's a native on the East. Always considered herself one, but she's an attorney, and she wants to take an active part in the Oak Truck, which I think is absolutely, and I think she'll fit right in with all the ladies there.
She can be on the committee, right? I mean, you don't necessarily have to be a voting member. She can be a member.
She'll vote. She'll be a lawyer. They need a lawyer.
They got a lawyer.
Who?
What's her name?
Heather Thornton.
And she worked for a law.
No, she wasn't a lawyer.
Anyway, I recommend Ms. Little. I think she's an excellent candidate.
And the other name? We have two names. We can vote on each one. And you can vote on as many as you want.
Recommended either one of these seven?
There was discussion at that meeting, but there was no
recommendation. I didn't remember them. Making any recommendations.
And it wasn't on their agenda either.
Mr. Tyler was recommended previously.
No,
it
wasn't. Well, Kirk Luther didn't give us his name.
There was no recommendation at the last meeting, Gary, last meeting.
No, I'm saying before that evening. And even before when all the other stuff was going on.
Can we go ahead and vote on Jerome first and Kathy second? And you can vote for each person if you want. You don't have to just vote for one, you just vote there and then read them.
Well, so, I mean, that's the Harvey's concern. I mean, shouldn't they make a recommendation?
That's what we've always
they
done
could,
before.
And they, honestly, could have been, but it wasn't on the agenda, and I don't think they found out until late. I don't know when they found out, but
they didn't find out until
that
before then.
Yeah, so that night.
So they couldn't have put it on the agenda.
Yeah, right.
So
we could defer it back to them. Tell them to meet well at 11.
Yeah, they're meeting then.
Well, they're got the letter you sent you? Well.
I'm sorry?
You still got the letter you sent you? I don't have a copy of it.
No, the drone center?
Yeah.
No, we would have it in our records, like 3 meetings ago, whenever it first brought up.
I got 3 or 4 meetings.
It's been a while.
Maybe we ought to refer it back to them, or let them.
No, Kirk.
Let them.
Kirk.
Come back with a recommendation.
Well, that's not the case, if you only did it last time with Heather Hardy, you know, you made a recommendation and it was good. So.
Yeah, we don't have to. Well, it's not required.
Yeah, okay.
So do we want to vote on these two names or defer? All right, the first name is Jerome Tyler, all in favor? All, no, you have to vote against this for the court.
Sorry?
You have to vote against for this court.
Doesn't work, it's a majority. Majority vote.
And then Kathy Yvette Little, all in favor? Next item is approval of obstruction. And the reason I asked this to be on here, we did our, what we call a budget workshop. And I think we got this at the last, and we didn't really, I kind of blew over it. And I don't know if anything needs to change or not, but I felt like there were some things I wanted to change, but maybe nobody else does, but that's beside the thing. So I wanted on here, we can talk about it. And then Bob knows what to put on the number that's coming to us.
Well, March 19th, first.
May 9th.
Of our budget, but it is a cash budget, we don't want money. We have to.
Well.
Have made changes.
If we had the workshop, we could have made changes at the workshop, but since we didn't, we didn't have the money we normally have tonight. I would have made some changes to it, and again, I'm going to go straight to it.
Are we going to have another workshop?
Because we were supposed to have. Is it tonight or?
No, we're supposed to have three.
No.
Yeah, that's 3 and 15 years. We always put a third one on there in case council wants to have it, so I'm sure Paul, but.
But we also would be voting first reading at the same night, so if we were to make changes that night, then we'd have to. And that's why I want to go ahead and put this on there, we can go over the changes, we want to make some do, if we don't, we don't. And then that's part of it. The only thing I felt like there was, and the main thing is the festival management. And it still sounds to me like it may be up in the air. But if we hire Bob as the coordinator, we don't need $6,000 or $7,000 or whatever for the administrator. We take that out of the expense side, leave it in there, so at the end of the year, we end up with $7,000 more. But that was my recommendation that.
I would say leave it in there.
That since we're. And it sounds like, I don't know, maybe they're still gonna, my idea was if we voted for Bob as coordinator and we took it out of the budget, then maybe they wouldn't have to meet May 4th, and do that. If we're not going to approve one May 19th, then I think we're spending their time and whoever comes in to interview time thinking that we're gonna hire somebody who maybe is not gonna come. But to me.
Well, Kathy had mentioned, and I think it was a laudable recommendation that a person may want.
Scott Bob?
Knowing how big a bite they're gonna take out of that steak. Work with Bob for a little bit. Because when I see the numbers that come back with the hours spent, I'm going to make a recommendation that the obstruct reimburse the town for some hourly costs. Just like we have with police department and town services with folks. If we're going to be honest and upfront about it,
well, I think that's what we call it that one.
We kind of put them into the budget.
We put them in the town budget and took them out of the obstruct.
Yeah, right. But I think we need to know what that number is. It's a magic number out there that can get construed. many different ways.
We won't know until October, like I pointed out, it's not a big burden yet.
No. You won't know until October, November, maybe even December.
Yeah. So anyway, that was my recommendation. Anybody else?
I would say leave it in, and we can move it.
Any other comments? Any other players?
Yeah, if I can point out one thing, Kirk had mentioned at the meeting about lowering it to $6,000, did he not?
Yeah, from 7 to 6 for the administrative position.
Oh, yeah, going back to.
Yeah.
Back line.
Tony, if you want to change that based on his recommendation.
I mean, they don't have to spend seven, they got to do it, they spend one.
The only thing I would say is if we're gonna do what Kathy and Harvey are talking about, I would say, if they're gonna pick somebody for next year, starting January 1st, and agree on whatever you're gonna pay them, and then if they want to pay them through shadow box for the next 4 months, then stipulate that. So that.
I can agree with that.
Clear. Instead of us hiring.
I don't think you expect them to do nothing.
Hire them starting January 1st, but for the next 3 months, 4 months, whatever it is, not necessarily till December, but just for now to October or whatever. And we're gonna pay them before that, I don't know, but whatever they choose. So that you get somebody lined up for next year. We don't pick somebody to do the interim, and then come January, we're gonna start over. This would be for next year's contract, if we make it for shadow. And they may decide to do it for nothing, and they decide to do it for $3,000, or whatever, and not $6,000.
It would be good to drop it on anybody, and then you have to do it hard, it's a learning process.
Yeah, but still, they're gonna.
It's a growing habit.
You know, I think that would get rid of the weak, too, if they're not really rich, I don't know, but that's what it.
Well, keep in mind, he's been truly a trained event organizer, he's very good at it, he was charged $20,000, I mean, do it, so.
So we're leaving the budget as is. Next item is presentation by citizens. This is for anyone who wants to address Portland County Council on anything, whether it's on the agenda or not. May do so at this time. All guests, you give us your name and address for the record. And anyone who would like to address the council. Seeing none, the next item is an executive session, and I did want to go back over whatever it was we did last meeting. For a legal matter, so is there a second?
Second.
Courtyard.
I talked to Brooks, he didn't have anything, but I don't know the history of that.
Well, there was a motion and a second, all in favor of going to executive session. All right. Is that okay?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go in there and discuss it, figure out what we stand for. We are out of executive session, and no decisions were made, and there is a. And we're.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Probably have a second.
No, we're not going there yet.
We're not?
No.
Oh.
We have a milestone here tonight.
Okay.
It's the chief's last meeting. And he's been sitting there since.
Yeah, okay.
2003 for me, I don't know about the rest of y'all, maybe longer than that anyway.
It truly has been an honor and a privilege to serve this city, and I've enjoyed working with all of y'all.
I still think y'all to go through the phaser one more time.
I've got my mission ticket to my ride on the Lightning, and I don't need to go again.
You go first.
I've been there.
I've ridden on the Lightning, I've been beaten with a stick, I've been sprayed with pepper spray, all of it.
I would say more, but I'm tearing up, so I'm not going to say.
Now, then what can you do to be chief, or is that just?
That was training and prep work.
Do we get tased here and pepper spray and all that? So is there a motion for
adjournment?
Motion second, so all in favor?
Aye.